Welcome back to Subiaco Oval. They have come from near and far to be here tonight. In excess of 40,000. This game has been sold out for almost 10 days. Can you believe it? Eagles and Swans 10 years ago, you'd have been lucky to get 15,000 at a Swans game here in the West. There is the coin toss in the middle of the ground. Chris Judd and Barry Hall going at it. And Chris Judd has won the toss and is going to left off screen. Conditions absolutely perfect. Currently 17 degrees, not a breath of wind in the ground. And I can tell you, it may get a little bit slippery later, a little bit dewy. But at the moment, no excuses. Should be an absolute beauty and the place is rocking.
Yep.
Thank you, Tim. And it does look a sensational sight, doesn't it, over Subi? Players moving into position. You can see the expected forecast for the night, 17. So it should be quite calm. There is the star of the finale of the grand final last year, quarters, Leo Barry. And at the other end, the other Barry, Barry Hall. And who will be going down onto him? We'll find out very, very shortly, Stephen Silvani. Who do you fancy tonight?
Well, I just think with the players that West Coast have out of the side, particularly in their midfield, Cox and Kerr are big losses, and an area that West Coast have really been struggling over the last month. And I just think that Sydney will go man on man tonight and try and close them down around the stoppages.
I don't think it's going to be pretty again, boys, but I certainly think I've changed my tip. I have Eagles on the books all week, and I now think Sydney will win.
It's going to be Hunter with the job down there on Barry Hall. There's Chad Fletcher. We're just about ready to go.
We are in the grand final rematch. Sydney versus West Coast. As these teams battle for a home final come September, Seedy with first hand on the ball. Spills free. And Stenglein was driven into the ground and he's got the first touch of the match. So Tyson Stenglein for the West Coast Eagles. Little dish. And that is an uncharacteristic turnover from Chris Judd. Don't see that too often. Kennelly goes to O'Loughlin, who's been in super form the last two or three weeks. Little chip into the pocket to Goods. And Adam Goods has also been in good touch this season. And he has got the mark, averaging 20 disposals. A centering kick. It's a good one. Hall flies, can't mark. Now it spills to Fletcher. Good shepherd off the ball, allows Fletcher to give it to Cousins. Back to Fletcher. Seavey, did he take it over the line? He did. We've got a throw in.
Just a couple of matchups in the West Coast forward line. Kennelly looks like he's gone to Hanson, which is an interesting lineup. Roberts Thompson got Hanson in the grand final. Roberts Thompson has gone to Stoker.
Matthews back in the team this week. Usually he gets a job. McVeigh pushing towards the line. There's.
Can you get a shot of Harry Hall, please?
So a bit of a strange old start so far. Swans doing all the attacking at this stage.
Seabee knocked it back over the line. And Matthew sees it safely over. So another throw in. As I said, boys, I don't think this is going to be a very pretty game by any stretch of the imagination. Probably a bit similar to last year's grand final, but I think we guaranteed a very tight contest. Jolly against Seabee. There's Buchanan, had a terrific grand final. Matthews back in the side, run down by Fitchery, threw that out. Umpire let it go. Kirk squares it up. Hall, yes! One-on-one with Hunter. Plenty of muscle from both those men. But Hall has won out. Now, this is a big kick for Barry Hall, who's been off target badly the last fortnight. But this is should be a gimme for Barry Hall. 44 goals, 23 for the year. Conversion rate of 66%. But as I said, the last couple of weeks, he's had the yips. He's only 15 metres out. And Sydney on the board with the first goal.
It's going to be the key question of the night, isn't it? Whether Hunter can hold Barry Hall and whether they can get the ball in there enough.
Well, you're spot on, Hutto. Obviously, Hunter went to Hall early in the grand final last year, and Barry Hall is a very, very good player up to half-time. This is the question. This is the man that really does ignite the Swans, and he's got off to a very good start.
It's the key matchup, Sauce, isn't it?
It is a big job for Hunter. Glass is expected to go for him. He's out of the side. Got a massive job.
Seabee And Jolly and Judd. Cousins, as he has been a lot this year, starting inside the 50. Likewise, this man, Embley, who leaves it behind. Barry with the clean-up job. Kennelly, there was nothing clean about that. Staker, who looks like he could be stalking goods.
And that's an interesting one with Embley starting forward. The Eagles love to use him on the wing as a switch player, but Embley's been very good this year, has kicked a number of goals for them, 20 so far for the year.
And he can take an overhead mark, Sauce, and obviously he knows how to run up and down the ground, so he's a dangerous player.
Well, he's got such great endurance, great reader of the football, but they've been forced to moving forward because they just don't have enough goal kickers at the minute, the Eagles.
Well, they are an attack and a chance. And Keith couldn't handle it. All hands on deck. You can see the numbers around the ball. Kirk in amongst it. The umpire showing plenty of patience, but eventually that runs out.
Well, I've got no doubt the Swans will be focusing at these clearances, at the stoppages, that they go one-on-one, close the Eagles down.
Well, Eagles, a hallmark of their game is their ability to score goals from the stoppages. That's been missing over the last few weeks. Look at that. Now the umpire's got impatient and he's plucked out a free and it's going West Coast way.
From the back of the head.
Selwood.
Knees hitting the back of the head. Right out.
Well, we heard that. Knees to the back of the head. Let's have a look at it.
Oh, that might give us a better view.
Against Jolly, was it?
Yeah, yep. Fair enough too. Well spotted.
Adam Selwood, just 5 goals, 4 for the year. Last week had the tough tagging job on Luke Hodge. Interesting diversion on the mark, but he's not put off. He's steadfast and levels it up.
That was well spotted by umpire Schmidt, wasn't it? It was in tight and close, but there was definitely a dodgy old knee to the back of the head, and that's got to be a free kick.
It is, and it's reckless by Jolly. I mean, it's 15 minutes out from goal. He doesn't need to do that. It's just a reckless free kick, something Paul Ruse won't be happy with.
There's Michael Gardner, reportedly has suffered from a virus all week, but he's in the team. No Cox tonight, and CB and Gardner will be doing the ruck work. 1 goal apiece here at Subiaco. CB got the tap. Judd's in there. Little soccer off the ground. McVeigh in hot pursuit. Put the head over the ball. He's immediately wrapped up.
Brian! Straight up. Good luck. Thanks, Jared. Don't hold. Don't block.
Plenty happening around the ball.
Straight up. Get him up.
Jolly, the tap. Spills to Buchanan. Breaks the Judd tackle. Now out wide in the direction of O'Loughlin. Oh, great skill from O'Loughlin. Did it beautifully, got rid of Jones. Now a chip to the 50. Vogels to Buchanan. Squaring kick to Hall. Couldn't quite get there. Tap forward by Bolton. McVeigh's there. Stenglein will concede the rush behind. How's that for skill from Michael O'Loughlin? Did it beautifully against Brett Jones.
And they do look dangerous down there in attack. Hearn marks the kick in. Already being pushed back, and this is dangerous. Waters almost turned it over. Stenglein goes in to try and assist. And there we go. We've seen one at either end.
Got him against Shane.
Free kick in front of goal.
Top of him. Thank you.
And it looks like Stenglein might have been the man.
Well, they just put themselves under pressure here, the Eagles. They should have rushed the ball through. 5 metres out from goal, and there we go, the free kick to Oku.
Well, if you're going to pay that, there's about 100 free kicks in every match. O'Keefe is directly in front of goal and slots it. Not an overwhelming response by the crowd to the goal.
No, it's not, but good start for the Swans. Let's have a look at the free kick there. Well, I think it's in the back. No doubt it's in the back, and the umpire was right there. A And a surprising move here, Rapunda up forward, Bevan picking him up. So a couple of surprise move by John Worsfold with Embley and Rapunda up forward.
So down it goes. Seavey the nice tap in the direction of Cousins, but O'Keefe got there first. And yet again, we will have a secondary bounce.
Good tackle. Well done.
Just going back to the Wirrpunda move up forward. They just struggled to crumb goals, the Eagles, particularly with Sampi out of the side and also the retirement of Matera.
Jolly to McVeigh. Handball intercepted by Selwood. Goods. Pounces. Kicks to the 50. Almost hacked out of midair by Hunter.
High fend off. Tap through.
It's a free kick.
High fend off. High fend off.
For a fend off.
Yeah, high fend off.
Against Stenglein, it's going to Jude Bolton. He sees an option and he finds his man.
And quarters. And quarters. This is where the Swans last year, when they beat the Eagles, their forwards were rewarded up on the lead. They took a number of uncontested marks inside their forward 50 and they're doing so early.
That was the fend-off we just saw. And Vogels playing his third match this season. He's played a total of 13 games for the Swans for the 8 goals. We'll be kicking from right on 50, slight angle. No breeze whatsoever here at Subiaco. It's a good-looking kick. The Swans have got their third.
Well, what a start for the Swans. This is the fend-off. Cops Bolton high, correct decision. And then Bolton uses his skill to be able to hit Vogels up on a lead. And Vogels makes the most of his opportunity.
Was impressive last week, Vogels. And a very vibrant Sydney Swans team have taken a 13-point lead. Now, which way is the whistle? It's another
against Braun.
Coming in too soon.
Yep.
Buchanan taking it out of the middle, generating plenty of ball for them. Bolton, too much on it for Hall, and not enough for O'Loughlin. But they are very, very lively, the Swans at the moment. Got some matchups working in their favour. No one in front of the two ruckmen. Jolly and Seabee. This is Dempster. Can he make an impact? Gave himself plenty of time to steady. And he did all the right things.
Hey, that was an impressive goal.
Fantastic. Well, we know that Dempster's got plenty of speed. A grand final player from last year. But just at the minute, the Swans are getting plenty of the ball inside their forward 50. 6 to the Eagles, 1. But this is great play by Dempster. More importantly, at full pace, was able to slot the goal through. Great start for the Swans.
And plenty of acceleration. Shook off Braun, didn't he?
He's quick.
A scintillating goal from Sean Dempster. And a scintillating start for the Sydney Swans. 4 goals, plays 1. Eagles lead a steady here. Graham, under immense pressure, has been pinged. Another free kick for Sydney.
360, Lima up now.
Don't hold! 4-2, the free kick count so far, Sydney's way. As out wide, Dempster, who booted the last goal, has got a paddock, has a bounce, draws the player, goes to O'Keefe, usually uses it well. He decides to pump it long. O'Loughlin's one out, got rid of his opponent, illegally, said the umpire, and advantage is paid. Bronx cheers from the crowd, and now it's the Eagles' turn to break. Solwood's got it on defensive 50.
He's looking for Embley initially, but that's been closed down. Got Hearn, and you can see where Punda.
And this is where the Eagles have struggled of recent times, that they haven't got their free-flowing game on. And they, when they're playing well, they move the ball very quickly.
Seavey presenting, all of a sudden thrust into the major ruck role at the Eagles with the injury to Cox. Gardner, of course, coming back, but Gardner starting on the bench. Hanson, another one who spent some time in the waffle before returning. Did okay last week. Staker trying to give him something on the wing, but he doesn't like anything. He's turned it straight into the lap of Ablett, who has to wait and wait because he had nothing immediately. Canelli. Now he likes Canelli's run. Trying to push off Hansen. He's got Hall deep. He's got Vogels as the other option. The best option of all might be 6 points. Almost.
Here's a poor kick inside. Here's a turnover. Poor kick by Hansen. The Swans had man on man. There were no options.
So Eagles under immense pressure. Brett Jones on defensive 50 goes to the contest. Oh, great mark, Andrew Embley. That's a beauty in front of Bolton, who is not an easy man to beat.
No, do you push him right here?
Oh, down goes umpire James. It's all happening at CB. Andrew Embley, averaging 19 disposals and 7 marks this year, kicked 20 goals. A long kick again to a contest. Lynch flies from behind. Jolly got the fist. Spills to Roberts Thompson. He has the quick release. Quick kick by Ablett back to the wing. Buchanan's there against Selwood. Coming in is Braun. Selwood's played well. Got caught high. Umpire let it go. Braun stripped of the ball. Buchanan has another go on hands and knees. Fed it out to Matthews. To Kirk. And away go the Swans again. Brett Kirk on the left. Shanks the kick. It's a bad turnover. And the Eagles are going to get it back.
Jolly's down behind play and has barely moved so far. We'll update you on that. In a moment, the Eagles industrious off half-back. High kick from Selwood after the ball from Fletcher. Now, we've seen this around the grounds a bit, Sos. Good's running with Judd at certain times. At other times, it seems to be Kirk. Not quite sure what they're doing with that matchup at the moment. Here's Wirpunda with the steal, though.
Jolly's in big trouble. Hutto's being taken off by two trainers.
It's on for Cousins here on the wing, and it's very open ahead. Lynch, can he have some impact? Yes, he can. Not paid. Over the line.
He's just got to take those, Lynch. There's Jolly coming off the ground.
Just the shoulder got dragged down a bit, did it?
Yeah. Hard to tell.
Yeah, was there some interference at the front of the pack? There was.
Not looking at the ball, blocking him like this. How's he going to get to the footy? You weren't looking at him.
Just Matthews at him, not the ball. On Fletcher.
Well, you think the Swans are going to have to rejig their back line?
Will Roberts Thompson have to go in the ruck?
We'll have to go in the ruck. It looks like Richards is going back.
That is a massive blow for the Swans. This is only the second time the Eagles have gone inside 50, and it's Graham with the launch, a low flying ball. Well done by Canelli. Now Roberts Thompson. He's taken it to ground. He may have some issues here. No.
Took possession, tackled straight away.
Here's another look at it.
He's been cleaned up by Matthews, it looks like.
So maybe a friendly fire.
Maybe it's just some concussion. Maybe he can come back on. Stenglein and Kirk this time in a war. And still the battle goes on. That's young Phillips in there, number 47. Uh-oh. Here is Chris Judd. Worked it out nicely. And Bo Waters not happy with himself.
Matthews, and in fact it was Fletcher that hit connected with Jolly's head, so it looks like it was Fletcher from the Eagles, completely accidental, to the wing, and that's a free kick against Ablett. It's going to Cousins, who gets up gingerly also.
Not advantage, not he's advantage.
Oh, right in the ribs, and he's had a couple of heavy knocks there in the last month.
Yeah, last week.
Last week, of course, against the Hawks, he got cleaned up by Buddy Franklin. Tim Gossage.
Yeah, Darren Jolly's okay. He's sort of wiping some blood away from the nose region, and they're just trying to work on that. He's okay. He started to come to. I wouldn't be surprised if we saw him again.
So Cousins. He still looks very sore, Cousins. He goes short to Hunter, who's called to go. Back to the wing, and he finds Graham. Jamie Graham, good young talent for West Coast. Seabee comes off and Gardner comes into the game for the Eagles. A long ball, looks for Hansen, strong mark, no. Yes, he's been paid the free kick.
Chopping of the arms.
Chop the arm, thanks, Simon.
Hansen's got plenty of players riding shotgun there. One of them is Braun. He goes out wide, very wide to Lynch. And that'll play right into the hands of Leo Barry.
Well, Quarters, that's twice Lynch has led to that boundary. And if the Eagles are going to kick goals, they've got to carry it through the middle. Very tough to kick him from that side.
Gardner against Roberts Thompson. Gardner easily, but he tapped it straight to Bolton. He got tackled beautifully. It spills to Judd. And the maestro has kicked the goal. Superb stuff from Chris Judd. Great tackle, caused a spill. And Chris Judd nails his first for the night.
Well, you called it quarters. It was the tackle. The tackle was an absolute beauty by Hearn. And Judd, all class there.
And he's going to have to turn it on tonight for the Eagles. Because the Swans mean business. They lead by 14.
This is interesting, Hutto. It looks like Ted Richards has gone into the ruck. Or is it Vogels?
No, it's Richards. You're right. They're sauce against Gardner. Don't want to get rid of... Don't want to sacrifice Roberts Thompson in defence.
Well, it's a strange one. Roberts Thompson has played in the ruck the last couple of weeks.
So they'll just try and nullify. It doesn't matter because Buchanan is the escapee from the centre square. O'Keefe, his preferred option, and came good in front of Hearn. Quickly back to Buchanan, who's starting to cut them up a bit. Sets it up. This is young Phillips, but here's Old Hall.
What a great kick.
Just for a moment, young Phillips looked like he was going to stand his ground.
And then he saw the bustler coming. He got out of the way. He's only 65 kilos,
tell you what, there's Barry Hall, but the kick was an absolute beauty. Just placed out in front. Super play, Swans.
And what a dangerous threat he will be tonight, Barry Hall. Already with one under his belt, now two.
Well, the Swans getting the ball out of the middle. It was Buchanan on his left foot, placed out in front for Barry Hall, and Barry Hall off to a flying start.
There's young Simon Phillips, 19 years of age, off the rookie list, playing his first game for the Swans. 65 kilos. Hutto, that's lighter than Stephen Silvani's backside these days.
But you're calling, aren't you, Quarters?
I won't give a comeback there, Quarters.
Jude Bolton, kick partially smothered.
No,
has another go at it. So does Selwood.
Fine.
Now, this is the area the Eagles need to get on top. Gardner up against Richards. Really, Gardner should be putting the ball to his on-ballers advantage. They need to win this area of the game now, the Eagles.
Oh, both ruckmen missed it. Another clearance for Sydney. That's Schneider to half forward. Keeping his feet was Hearn. Did it nicely. And a great little handball over to Brett Jones, who shows a lot of dash. Kicks to a one-on-one. Staker, too good. 65 from home. The leads are on. He decides to bang it long. Lynch is getting back. Quinten Lynch has got the sit. Can't take the mark against Barry. Ball still alive. Suck it off the ground. A poster.
Leo Barry, you star.
Well, it's probably the third contest where Lynch has almost taken the mark. He's got to grab him. He's got to grab them because he needs to give his on-ballers confidence to kick to him.
It is an interesting move with Punda going forward, isn't it? Last week he was tagged out of the game by Tim Clark. Had to go forward at one stage. As you mentioned, with no Sampi and no Matera in the team these days, it's a different looking forward line. Now Bevan, who's been back in the team for a couple of weeks and done okay too. That not his best kick and made it very tough for Leo Barry, but nothing's too hard for his dancing feet. And he has an outlet. And it's Brett Kirk, who has Richards pushing up on the wing. And didn't quite complete it.
Hit the ground, Teddy.
Stenglein's hurt off the ball, Hutto. In their forward 50, the Eagles still down on the haunches.
Again, Gardner with the extra centimetres, but they don't make the most of it. The Boltons combine and the Swans again looking like adding to their score and looking more like it now. Fosdyke, Phillips outsized back there by Jones. And Selwood has them away And Ablett just couldn't get there to stop the rampaging Bo Waters, who in some ways was committed to running on.
Good call by the umpire. It
was.
Seven touches for Selwood. Waters has got it at half back for West Coast. Kicks in the direction of Gardner. Well done, Richards, to get a fist at the vital moment. A throw in smack bang on the centre wing as Hansen comes off. And Cousins, who's had those ribs checked, comes back on. Judd also sitting down for a break at the moment. He's getting ready to come back. Five disposals for Judd so far. From the throw in, Richards on hands, and he's fed it out brilliantly to Kirk, to Buchanan, who gives it to Schneider. Now Schneider, oh, his kicks loose off the side of the boot. Will McVeigh get there first? Hall's free if he can get him. McVeigh, some fancy footwork, short and finds Schneider. Not 15, said the umpire. Schneider caught high, plays on. Right foot kick is offline, and it's a point.
Big call by the umpire.
I thought it was 15.
Yeah, I reckon you've got to.
Anyway.
Got to pay that.
Right there, Paul.
Now we'll put her at the other end of the ground. Now that doesn't mean that he's been moved there necessarily, but maybe he has. Braun. Not much happening for him, so he's forced to go for Hunter. He's maybe trying to run off Barry Hall and create some doubts in Hall's mind about staying back. Crowd have been cut out of the game largely. Good to see Jolly back on his feet. Gardner, you'd think he'd be able to outmark Richards most times.
Judd back on for Stenglein.
And Good still running with him.
And this is the dominating stat of the quarter so far. The Swans 11-4 inside 50s.
And they've capitalised to a pretty reasonable extent. They lead by 20. The Eagles again cut off at the pass, but Staker finds a way. Some help down there. Now, Canelli. Goods, Kirk, Schneider, and the Swans, well, it was opening up for them, but here comes Wirrpunda, trying to storm off halfback, leaves it behind. Jones retreating the Eagles. Banfield, that's more positive. This is Chad Fletcher. They're working hard. Embley perhaps could have got a free. Bevan knew what he was doing. Kirk, three Eagles to contend with, and he's going to be pinged.
So Braun gets up with a free kick. Kicks to the 50. Lynch against Barry. Barry just nudged him beautifully under the ball. Too experienced for Lynch there.
Well, the third time Lynch has led to that pocket and to the boundary line. He's got to lead straight up the ground.
Tim Gossage.
Darren Jolly's been spoken to by the doctor, walking the boundary. Questions and answers. He's right to come back on. Might wait till quarter time.
Inside the Eagles 50. Judd's in there. And another stalemate.
And if I can just get back to the
Lynch. Free kick, sorry, Steve.
If I can just get back to the Lynch leading, there's no possible way his smaller players can crumb his hands or crumb the ball from where he's actually leading. He needs to lead up the corridor so at least it brings his smaller players into play.
Ball's on centre wing to Bevan. He's run down. Dempster. He's game tackled by three West Coast Eagles. Beautifully done by West Coast. They're starting to hunt in packs. They're down by 20 points late in this first quarter in the grand final rematch.
And Dempster over the top of Braun.
Top again. Straight on.
Incorrectly.
Free kick. And straight back. Straight back to him.
So Michael Braun on the wing for the West Coast Eagles. Cousins and Fletcher as short targets, but nothing longer. And Cousins, it was out of his reach. Just what Ablett wanted. O'Loughlin Wirrpunda. O'Loughlin means business. Perhaps got one high there from Banfield, who found a way. Well done by the experienced Banfield. Goods and Judd. What an amazing matchup that is. Not one we expected, Sauce.
No, but looking forward to see how this pans out, that contest.
So far, Adam Goods, four possessions. Chris Judd, five possessions and a goal.
Two Brownlow medalists going head-to-head. Leo Barry to Bolton, who's got plenty of room at half-back. Craig Bolton.
Swans will be happy to just about erode a bit of time here, won't they, Steve, with their 20-point lead?
Well, no doubt. That the this quarter's worked out very nicely for him. It's basically taken the crowd out of the equation. And to go in to quarter time, three goals up, Paul Lewis would be delighted.
So tempo footy by the Swans as they protect this 20-point lead at quarter time. Bolton short to Richards, who's doing the ruck work at the moment with Jolly off concussed. There's a lead from Hall ignored.
Let's move it on.
Richards now goes short to O'Keefe. Good mark.
And this is what they'll do. They continue to honour the lead.
Jude Bolton in between two Eagles. We're punted in well to get there and spoil. Now the turnover goes to the wing and finds the sliding Lynch, who is just at the moment not being able to hang on to the Sharon, Stephen Silvani.
He's got to start taking those marks. It was a poor kick. We've got to say it was a poor kick, but once again along the boundary line.
So under 2 minutes for the Eagles to try and nab one back. Judd and Cousins. Ball just not falling for them at the moment. Massive credit to the Swans, though. Ablett, who was unsuccessful in trying to quell Judd in a couple of finals last year, has got the job on Cousins tonight instead. Richards and Kirk able to combine. It's a tough life as a tagger, isn't it? You get some relief from tagging Judd and you go on to Ben Cousins.
And not too happy with himself there. Quinten Lynch, maybe he wasn't too happy with the kick. Said half forward for the Swans. Kirk stripped of the football. Bodies diving everywhere. Finally comes out to the veteran in Banfield. Little chip in the middle was a beauty. Cousins couldn't take the mark. Has time to recover. Got Embley in support. Ignores him. Goes to Selwood. Disposal number 8 as he kicks the half forward. The spore from behind was O'Keefe. Tap forward by Lacroix. Now a chance for Rowan Jones. To Judd. He backed himself and he got run down. Should have been a free kick to Sydney. Nevertheless, they have the numbers, so it's okay for them as Goods goes to halfback. It is desperate stuff out there. Knock forward, only as far as Fletcher. He breaks the McVeigh tackle. Now on the left boot to half forward and finds Jones. This is Rowan Jones as the Eagles continue to run. Selwood found some room, goes for home. Magnificent goal from the West Coast Eagles. Superb football. Adam Selwood has been on fire. He has had 9 disposals, and that is a great goal set up by Judd, who tried to run the break the tackle. That should have been a free kick, I thought.
100%. 100% it should have been a free kick, but this is what the Eagles need to do. They need to carry the ball through the corridor. They need to find options. They've got to start getting some run. They did so on that occasion, and it was a terrific goal by Selwood.
2 to Selwood now. He has had a magnificent first quarter. As Paul Roos watches on.
And there's where Apunda started the game up in the forward line, has now gone to fullback.
That will give Paul Roos something to think about on quarter time. Still just under a minute to do some more damage. Richards, though, doing the rucking and the roving. O'Loughlin, acrobatic, over to Goods. This will really sting the Eagles. Wow, what a reply from Adam Goods. Going head-to-head with Chris Judd. A goal for each of the Brownlow medalists in the opening term. And this rematch really living up to the hype.
And we just saw Goods just stream out of the middle there. Judd was nowhere to be seen, but Goods ran hard forward, got on the end of it, and kicked the goal.
And a bold move, really, isn't it, by Paul Roos? It certainly gives Chris Judd something to think about defensively, which he really wouldn't be used to.
And you know that Goods can take a great overhead mark. And they'll try and kick it high to him when he's on the one-on-one contest with Chris Judd.
In a great first quarter, had everything. And that man, Adam Selwood, 2 goals, 9 disposals. It's been brilliant. Richards, the release to O'Loughlin. It's a throw, says the umpire. But that is quarter time. And Sydney have a 20-point lead at the first break, 6-3. Plays 3-1, Stephen Silvani. Well,
great start by the Swans. They've taken the crowd out of the equation. They've kicked 6 goals to 3 in that first quarter. They've won the inside 50s, dominated in that area, but they're winning the clearances around the ground. That's the most important factor where the Swans have really been suffering the last couple of weeks.
So the Swans by 20. Barry Hall's kick 2. He's their multiple goal scorer, while for the Eagles, Adam Selwood has also booted two. A Saturday night special from Subiaco Oval, and it was a great first quarter. Sydney out to a 20-point lead against the West Coast Eagles. 6-3 plays 3-1, Hall 2 for the Swans. Selwood, 10 disposals and 2 goals was the star for West Coast in that first quarter. Stephen Silvani, you're not happy with Quinten Lynch.
Well, I'm not happy the fact that he's not holding on to his grabs. He's a big man. There's nothing wrong with his work rate, but he's got to lead to the right spots, and when he gets his hand to the football, he's got to hold on to it. He nearly takes marks, and that's his problem at the minute. He's going to make it very difficult for his on-ballers to have some type of confidence in going to him. And this has been one of the problems as well. He's been leading out very wide to the boundary line.
Tim Gossage, the big injury in that first quarter was the Swans ruckman. Darren Jolly, how is he at quarter time with that concussion?
They worked very hard on him at quarter time quarters. The medical staff, the doctor, the physio, and then the ruck coach working with him. Here he kept some friendly fire from Chad Fletcher on the way through. Got a whack to the nose. Didn't look 100% for much of the sort of time he was on the bench, but here they are working with him. They spoke to him. They got his faculty. Want to know if these faculties are all together. And he said, yeah, I'm ready to go. They gave the thumbs up to Paul Roos, and he will start in the middle of the ground. The message in the Sydney Swans camp was, let's worry about the next 30 minutes. John Worsfold spent a long time working on his matchups for the second term.
Tim, Ben Cousins got a heavy knock, I think it was about 3 weeks ago, and then got cleaned up by Buddy Franklin last week in the Hawthorn game and copped another one tonight. He must be very ginger.
Absolutely. He does cop a lot of heavy knocks around the rib and back region, and his back has created some problems over the last season or two, but he's very courageous. He's up and running, and they certainly need him because they're under enormous pressure. He will start the game, of course, on the field in the second term.
He is one of the most courageous players going around. There's the Hall and Hunter matchup. No Glass tonight, a late withdrawal. A huge body blow for West Coast, and Selwood and Buchanan, two men who had excellent first quarters.
And the second is underway. Jolly back in the thick of the action. And it's Adam Goods who kicked that late goal, who gets the Swans going out of the middle again. Some help from Bevan and then Bolton. Wonderful smother from Stenglein, the glove. And in the end, they forced the turnover. Fletcher quick to get it moving. Himberley had to work back. Bolton always had the footy as his main objective, so no problems there. Dempster left it behind. Butler now working at the coalface.
My ball.
And it is a match that we became very familiar with, the style of last year with the Swans.
Now, that is the West Coast forward line. They've gone with four talls up there. Gardner, Lynch, Hanson and Embley. Not too sure whether that's the right move.
Handicapped by the bounce, the Eagles, and it's Bolton who now gives Buchanan a bit of running to do. He was fantastic in the opening two, and Buchanan, and he continues in the same fashion. O'Loughlin.
Just about kick it from there.
Just about, yeah. Michael O'Loughlin, 22 goals, 19 for the year. He doesn't agree. He goes for Goods instead. Much better angle. A little bit further to travel. I reckon Adam Goods thinks that he can with the right connection. Scored an important goal early in this second quarter. They've scored 6 goals already, the Swans. We were looking it up at quarter time. Quarters of the grand final last year, they only managed 8.
Yeah, 8-7.
They'll need more than that tonight. Goods doesn't really hit it the way he would have liked. It was all Eagles back there. Not the right connection, Soss. And the margin now creeps up to 21.
Quick kick in by West Coast. Find Selwood. 6 kicks, 4 handballs in the first quarter. 3 marks, a clearance, a tackle, and 2 goals. Oh, gee. He almost cost his team another one there. They get out of trouble, West Coast. Weirpunda to Fletcher. Back to Weirpunda at halfback. He's weighing up the options. Not a lot to go to. Now he chips, and it was a good option in the end as he found Staker. Brent Staker, been quiet so far. The lead provided by Hanson. Only man inside 50 is Lynch for West Coast. Now he provides the lead. Gardner from the side. Nice mark against Roberts Thompson.
Good mark. They need one of their four tools to start taking grabs.
Gardner loads up. Long ball to the tip of the goal square. Well read by O'Keefe, who is superb mark for his size overhead. In fact, he's 6'2 in the old scale, so he's taller than he looks. And he's great overhead. And he managed to cut that one off, and he went short to Kirk.
As Bolton is a short option, or Roberts Thompson, perhaps, he may go for. Well, who knows who he was going for, because miscued poorly. And the ball over the line. 6-4 plays 3-1. Brett Kirk, 7 possessions for the night.
Scrappy kick, Kirky.
Just down a bit with his possessions this year, from 21 down to 18. The Eagles back into action, where Pundy, you can see, totally bereft of options. He managed to hang on to the ball long enough to give his forwards a chance. That looked high. Embley to line up, despite the despair from Craig Bolton.
Did it well, Embley. He sensed that Bolton was on him, and I think he almost played for that free kick. He fell to the ground.
Free kicks, West Coast 10, Sydney 4.
Well, he did it well, because the contact was definitely there. So 21 points the margin. Andrew Embley, 20 goals, 20 going into today's match. It's his first real scoring opportunity. He's cutting it fine. Too fine. And, this crowd, we have not heard a lot from them tonight, because they haven't had a lot to yell about at this stage.
So Ty Connelly doing the kicking in. Told to hurry it up. His kick finds Jude Bolton. He's one of the few Swans that's had a really consistent start to 2006. His numbers are well and truly comparable to last year. Jude Bolton, second in the AFL in clearances, second in tackles, 6 in contested possessions, 20 disposals and 6 clearances a game. Throw in. CB the tap, Judd over the line.
That was an amazing stat on Judd. No touches in 32 minutes. He's had 7 for the game. He did kick a goal.
In it comes. Jolly back in the game. Stenglein all wrapped up.
Let him go. Good tackle.
Bounce right on centre wing. Ty Connelly also been very quiet the last 20 minutes. CB the tap. Selwood ridden by Buchanan.
And this is what Sydney would have been looking at the start of the game. Close them around the stoppages. Third ball up.
Here's the matchups as they exist at the moment. Man on man. Another bounce on centre wing as Jolly and CB wrestle. Good's third man up. Judd snapping at his heels. Well done by Goods. Hurried kick to the 50. Hall caught behind Hunter. Well played by Hunter. Kirk fed it out to Hall. Good tackle. Stenglein sees him over the line.
Now, they're the tall forwards for West Coast. It's just so important that they work for each other. It's something that the West Coast forwards don't do very well. They've got to create opportunities for each other.
So the arm wrestle continues here at Subiaco. Judd getting frustrated. Seabee looking around and only saw Swans jumpers initially. There's Rowan Jones working for Fletcher, just hacking it forward. Hansen behind Kennelly. Ablett, Matthews, O'Keefe. And again, Ablett just a little sloppy. But it's the Eagles that need to try and retake the initiative here as we continue to look at the matchups. Now at the Eagles end of the ground. Jolly. Back in action, Dempster, Staker, Bevan, Kirk. Pretty easy for Ripunda that time. Now he's got Graham breaking through the middle, but they haven't been able to, as you've said a number of times, haven't been able to switch like they normally do.
Well, this is the thing. Embley's playing up in the forward line. Usually he's the switch player. He or Cox, of course, Cox is out of the side, but Embley's the one they usually go through the wing.
Now, we'll need to have another look at this. That was high on Jones, who's impressive so far tonight, Brett Jones. It was late, didn't mark it, so no 50. We heard the explanation from Scotty McLaren. Now, this is Ben Cousins trying to move into action, trying to get the Eagles going, generate some footy for them. Judd and Good's over their head. Left to Fletcher. Dangerous ball, Lynch involved. You can see Jolly.
Barry just did so well. He knew it was two on one. He just held his ground. He took Lynch out of the contest. Enabled Jolly just to fist the ball through.
Bit of advice there for Tyke. And the short kick in again from Kennelly. Finds his man. Fosdyke had an outstanding grand final. Probably his best game he's ever played for Sydney. Finished with 26 disposals. Kennelly to Craig Bolton at half-back. Now, what's he got on offer? Not a lot, so he's forced to double back. Now the long lead from Hall. And he takes it on centre wing. Kirk has run hard. So has Stenglein, who forced the spoil. Now the Eagles away. Breaking kick to half forward. Oh, getting back. Good mark, Bolton. Short to his namesake in Jude. To Kennelly. Swans looking to create something here. Little give and go to Goods, who decides to kick himself. Long ball to half forward. Good kick. Not taken by O'Keefe. Nice build up here from Sydney.
Very nice. A little subtle kick, perhaps a little too subtle. Bevan unusually playing as a lead-up forward there. Nowhere to go for Jones. Absolutely nowhere to go.
And this is where Sydney was so good in their grand final win last year. Their pressure to hold the ball inside their forward 50, it stops the West Coast rebounding.
Banfield in there. Now, Jolly, Schneider. Tough one for Kirk. And the Swans taking no chances. They lead by 19. Barry Hall waiting back in the goal square. You can see him at the top of your screen. Just the four possessions, two goals. They'd love to get it down there again. Initiative shown by Ablett. Had a good plan, just couldn't execute it. Selwood and Fletcher, the leading possession winners on the ground for West Coast with 11, and Goods, who leads all comers with 12 for the Sydney Swans. Again, Jolly, not that many numbers around this one. So some space for Snyder, not to the side he wanted to go though. Buchanan, pile out to all flow. Fletcher, Fosdyke, his turn to appeal. McLaren not interested. Tim Gossage.
Chris Judd's gone back to the goal square, trying to get Goods back there. Bolton's now gone with him, so trying to isolate Judd.
Kirk in the forward pocket. Oh, he's got to be good here. It's a close call. Just offline from Brett Kirk. It's Sydney by 20. So Eagles taking plenty of time to bring it in. Good punter's kick in finds Gardner.
Kick it now!
Awkward looking kick. Poor one from Gardner, really, to be honest. And easy pickings for Barry Hall, who goes long into the pocket. O'Loughlin uses the muscle there. Schneider ran out of space.
Can we just see Brett Kirk having a word to Schneider? Should have given off the handball. There's Chris Judd, full forward. Bolton picking him up. Bolton would feel comfortable back there on him.
Gardner just smashes it forward for West Coast. Bad bounce for Banfield. Fletcher's in there. Hunter, gang tackled by four Swans.
You can never feel comfortable standing next to Chris Judd.
I'm just going to correct myself there. Maybe not so comfortable, Hunter.
That's right up here, too wet. 45 out from Sydney's goal. Jolly the tap. Schneider. Just hesitating momentarily there was Butler. Got to be careful, I guess, when players have got their heads over the ball now. And another ball up. Still 45 out from Sydney's goal.
We just have a look at this. The Swans are spreading in their forward line.
Oh, great tap to McVeigh on his right boot. And it's way offline. Nicely worked, though.
Yeah, you just saw the plays, the forward line players, and particularly the on-ball players of the Swans, just spread in that stoppage there. McVay almost made the most of his opportunity.
Kicked two goals in each of his last two games, McVay. Jones, good clearance for Gardner. Now they start the break and push up. It's Hunter who's trying to work Barry Hall over. Jolly tries to give him a chop out, but well done by the Eagles. Jones and Cousins. Lynch and Hanson.
Well done, Barry.
Roberts Thompson. Haven't seen much of him. Was that high? It was.
Well done, Barry. Going back with the flight of the ball. Super play.
Only two possessions for Roberts Thompson. Fosdyke. All the players on this side of the ground. He looked to the other side, but there was no one there. Kirk wanting to involve Leo Barry on the way out. That branch from half back to half forward. And that's well placed for Ben Matthews. Had to go back to the Sydney reserves and earn his spot, which he quietly did. Into the forward pocket. Hall can't take it. O'Loughlin again is lurking. Jones takes it over. And really nothing happening in this second quarter. Action aplenty in the opening term.
Like old times now. It'll suit the Swans. O'Loughlin doesn't hurry it. Looks for Hall. Getting there to spoil at the last second was Graham. Well played, West Coast. Butler to Banfield. And the old timer. Raking left foot kick. And Staker did beautifully to work his way to the front against Canelli.
Got to get it in a jug.
That was superbly done by Staker. Now, what's he going to do? He goes short. And the diving mark's taken by Hanson. Chips into the pocket. Judd's there. Cut off well by McVay. Put the body on the line. Judd has another go. Rowan Jones is in there. Back of the pack, Butler. And Judd fed it out. Cousins got dealt with after he released the ball. Free kick to West Coast. Cousins into the corridor and finds Gardner.
We've got numbers back for the Swans.
Lynch was back on Craig Bolton and they just couldn't get the ball into him quick enough. Rapunda over the top. Really made it tough for Graham. Well done by Snyder, who was outsized and he's caught one. And he cops another one as he gets to his feet just at the bottom of the screen. Look at the marks inside 50.
And that's their problem. Their big men aren't catching the football. The problem is they're getting it in too slow. They're waiting for leads rather than wielding around and the forwards being on the move.
That was great stuff by Gardner. Rapunda and Selwood can't capitalise. Snyder, slick, perhaps too slick. And Hunter able to win one battle against Hall. Out to Rapunda. Safety first for the Eagles. Having to go back before forward. Graham spots Jones clear. On the wing. Nothing doing for him, though, really.
And this is where they're being slow.
Hanson wants it long. He's one out with Roberts Thompson. Here comes a flying leap over the top from Staker. He couldn't take it. He gets a second chance. Hanson. Now Cousins. Can someone take an opportunity for the Eagles? An emphatic no.
Cuz, own man got you, okay?
Battered and bruised, Ben Cousins. It'll take a lot to stop him.
War of attrition at the moment. Bad bounce by the ump. Kirk tapped it to Roberts Thompson. Kick under pressure, back into the centre square.
Well done.
Attacking it was Jude Bolton. Well done, said Steve Silvani. Now Bolton fed it out to O'Loughlin, but he was pushed. And it's a free kick going Sydney's way.
Well, you just know Jude Bolton is going to attack the ball with 100% commitment every time he goes for it.
There are some players really blowing hard down there, Tim Gossage. The rate of interchange is incredible at the moment.
Absolutely, quarters. And it always seems to happen about 15 to 17 minute mark. And let me tell you, we've played 17 minutes in this second quarter. Has not been a goal. Sydney would be loving it.
Sydney 22 interchanges, West Coast 16. As the free kick is given away by Hall to Graham. He goes short to Brett Jones. Kicks towards Hanson. He's starting to come into the game a little bit. Couldn't mark that one. Richards. Well done by Lynch. advantage. No, free kick coming back, it's going Sydney's way.
And we just see the leads by the West Coast forward along the boundary. They need to be able to look inside, get some run inside so they can carry the ball through the corridor.
No goals in this second quarter so far.
Roberts Thompson didn't really think through that all that well. To the advantage of the Eagles, that's a free kick to Rowan Jones. Barry Hall not happy. You can hear the response from the crowd. And it's Jones, who's looking up now. Already the Swans pushing numbers back. Play on the call. Goods. Able to dump Waters. Now, Leo Barry going to work with Bolton.
Goods.
Oh, he's free. He can stroll in from there. Adam Goods. And the West Coast Eagles have got a big, big problem at Subiaco.
Well, we just see skill errors. Eagle players putting each other under pressure. Missed kick. Ball goes over the back. Barry cleans up. Goods all alone in the forward half, in the Swans forward half.
It took 18 minutes. We finally got a goal in the second quarter, and a decisive goal it was. There's the clearances, 20 to 10 in favour of the Swans, and the margin now is a game-high 26 points. CB the tap, Richards follows it up. Judd pinned by two Swans. Forced to release the football. Ablett has the kick smothered. And yet another stalemate.
And you would have thought at the start of the game the Swans would have pinpointed the clearance situation, particularly with Cox and Kerr out of the side. They would have thought that they had the advantage in that area.
Well, the matchup's working a treat for Paul Ruse so far. Swans with the clearance again. Buchanan. Oh, brave stuff there. That was by Waters. Head over the footy. But again, the Swans win out the clearance. Ablett scrubs a kick to Vogels, who had to sit down for a breather a moment ago. Graham, he's got the free kick. Well played, Jamie Graham. There's the Waters. Copped a high knee from Canelli. Oh, Hanson. Just a lapse of concentration.
Well, it is a lapse of concentration, but it also is the fact that the Swans defenders have been tight on their forwards. There, he may have thought someone was behind him, you never know, but that's what can happen. Put enough pressure on your opponent, mistakes happen.
Richards the tap to his opposing ruckman, Seabee, who wobbles the kick to the 50. Roberts Thompson attacks it, so does Hanson. Now Braun, Judd loses a handle on it. Vogel's off for another break. Goss, he looks absolutely spent.
Absolutely, he's been puffing and panting almost his entire quarter. Let me just say, on this side of the ground, it is very slippery underfoot. No excuses for Hanson dropping the mark, but it is very slippery close to this boundary line.
Chance here for the Eagles, and boy, do they need one. Snap by Hearn. Went straight to Canelli. Scrubby old kick, fortunately found Craig Bolton. Got it to Buchanan, a high ball to the wing. Flying was Dempster, got pushed. Back to top of the arm, says umpire James. So coming back to the Sydney Swans. Look at Goods working hard, running off Judd.
He's only had a three-minute break so far in this game.
Oh, Goods. Dempster caught in two minds. Wonderful smother by Braun. Bad turnover. Now can the Eagles make Sydney pay? A diving mark is paid. It's Lacroix. Mark Lacroix kicks to Hanson. He doesn't muck up this one. So it just shows you at this level, Soss, you make a mistake and you can pay the ultimate price.
Yeah, it's the quick turnover. It's the smother. Let's have a look at this. Great effort. They need a bit more of that.
Believe it or not, this is West Coast's first mark inside 50 for the night. And it is just inside 50. And Hanson is a tough kick from here, but he needs to nail the goal. Ashley Hanson kicked 9 goals, 8 this season. In he comes. It's not going to make it. And that's a mark in the goal square. It is to Leo Barry.
Just shouldn't happen. Just shouldn't happen from the Eagles. The amount of tools they've got, That needs to come to ground.
Kirk and Matthews. And now Bolton. O'Keefe, the only option in short. Hall, the longer choice. Hunter, well done.
He's fought back on Hall nicely, hasn't he?
Oh, well, you just know. He very rarely gets beaten.
Barry Hall, 6 possessions, 4 marks, 2 goals. Amazingly this year, the Swans' record on the road is superior to their record at home. They've won 3 out of 8 games at home.
In their possession.
And if they win tonight, it'll be 6 out of 7 on the road, which is quite amazing.
They managed to shut down Selwood in the second quarter. This is his just his second disposal for term 2.
11 in total. He's kicked 2 goals. And that's pretty well placed. Ben Cousins had time to clean up there. McCrae presented well, did everything but take it. Kennelly bodies him out of it. McVeigh, good supporting cast, and they get it over. So the Sydney Swans making all the right moves at the moment. Can they maintain the intensity? You know that if the Eagles start to come, the crowd will lift and try and get them back into it. Good work from Hearn. And now Jones goes for Hansen again. He's the most likely avenue to goal, but Bolton backs up Roberts Thompson. Fosdyke, he's got O'Keefe over the top. Hall tells him to go to O'Keefe. And Hall will double back and work up around the 50. Nothing stopping him that time. Bevan pushing inside 50. McVeigh is deep as well. O'Loughlin and Goods. Goods versus Judd. Not quite. Rupunda, Selwood. Hearn. Straight to Hall.
Oh,
just
Torpy.
Bangs it back. Rupunda. Trying to ride it all the way, but out of bounds.
Don't you love the old Torp? Don't see it too often. Chance here for the Swans. They lead by 26, kicked the only goal of the second quarter. Seabee. Only went as far as Goods. Phillips, the first gamer, stripped of the football by Selwood. Selwood has another go at it. Caught high. And Adam Selwood comes up with the siren. That was the free kick. The Eagles work it to half-back Banfield. Just keeps it in play. Nicely worked as he kick finds Hansen, who finally grabbed onto it. He's working very hard though, Soss. Hansen.
Oh, he does. He comes up at it. That's one thing he does do.
And his kick finds Staker.
This is where he's got to get it in.
Staker. Oh, it's a bad, bad option. Put Waters right under the hammer. Fosdyke to Matthews. He'll be happy to see it over the line. And that's where it goes.
And Quarters, that's what I talk about, working for each other up forward. It's something they don't do. They don't create space for each other. They're very slow at trying to get the ball into their forward line to give their forward line players a one-on-one chance.
Here's Adam Goods again, creating havoc at both ends.
No one to kick to.
No, nothing for Buchanan. He doesn't mind, though. He'll just keep on going. Here's Phillips. Gets his first kick, and it's a good one, or good enough, not quite for McVeigh. He just didn't have solid footing. And the Eagles through Rupunda, Banfield. Jones now, a couple of Joneses combining. This is Rowan Jones, but Goods again, playing some sort of game. Stenglein is now running with Adam Goods. Here's McVeigh, Hall is long, there's an extra man back for the Eagles to contend with. McVeigh doesn't take them on. Instead, gives Buchanan the opportunity for his 12th possession.
We punters had 11 disposals for the quarter, Anthony.
Just poking. Why not? The man on the end of it is the most dangerous man perhaps out there for the Swans. Barry Hall.
They're all big kicks tonight, but gee, this would make it 32 on the halftime break.
Two goals for the night, 2 straight for Barry Hall. 7 marks. And gets the job done. Oh, the Eagles. Eagles on half-time are in massive, massive trouble. John Worsfold will have to do some of his very best work at half-time, Soss.
And we just have a look at this. Barry Hall times his lead, directs traffic up there. A number of West Coast players dropping back into the hole, but not one player gets body on body to Barry Hall.
Well, won't a Swans win tonight? There's a long, long way to go. Won't that really make it interesting in the top eight?
Sydney have not won at Subiaco since 2000. And they're well on the way at half-time. They're going to lead by 32 points.
And he's back, advantage!
Advantage paid. Not enough time for Brett Kirk to do something here. But Sydney will go to half-time more than satisfied. They lead by a whopping 32 points. They kick two goals that quarter. West Coast Eagles just two behinds.
Yeah, it's just hard to see where West Coast are going to kick their goals. None of their forwards are playing particularly well, but Sydney, to their credit, are playing super football and winning the football.
Saturday night football coming up shortly. We hear from injured Eagles ruckman Dean Cox. The main break, Sydney by 32. So ready for action in the third term. It's the Sydney Swans by 32 points in the grand final rematch. And the opening bounce favours West Coast. CB knocks it forward. And here's Farrah Butler, who's stripped of the football. Banfield's in there now. Judd just throws it onto the boot to the 50. Roberts Thompson waits for it to bounce. Staker got it out to Graham. Here we go for West Coast. But Graham's kick misses to the right. Nevertheless, a positive start for the home team in this third quarter.
Just hasn't been happening for the Eagles tonight. Canelli, Barry, Bolton is the long target, Embley and Butler to contend with. That's Butler on the bottom of it all. Cousins trying to get them going. Staker, Roberts Thompson and Stenglein. Now the race is on. Good body work by Quinten Lynch. Desperation! And the right amount of accuracy as well. Is that going to be the thing that gets them going? Big Q.
Well, they needed something. And Quinten Lynch needed something. And he was very good here. Held his feet. Got his opponent off the ball. Great snap. They needed something to spark this team. Could this be it?
Well, Quinten Lynch needed to do something, and he has delivered. He's kicked the goal of the night so far. Good use of the body and a nice snap. And that'll spark West Coast, both on the ground and in the stands. Bring their supporters into the match.
Jude had in the end.
First touch of the night for Quinten Lynch.
Thanks, Jude. Thanks, mate.
And the margin back to 25. CB lost his footing. Jolly had a fresh air. He fell back into the hands of CB. Got it to Judd. Again, a quick kick to half four. They're getting it moving quickly. Roberts Thompson couldn't take the mark. Picked off by Canelli. Good kick. Out to the wing and finds Jude Bolton. He's got goods at half forward. Best on ground, Adam Good so far. Long kick inside 50. Eagles have the numbers. Couldn't take the mark. Snaffled by Vogel. He lets it go. And now West Coast out of trouble in defence. We're Punder. Possession number 16. And a little chip to half back and finds Judd, and he's off.
He's starting to find it now, and that spells danger for the Sydney Swans. So a really positive start here, Soss, to this second half.
Yes, and John Worsfold tried to get his forward line moving again. He's got Lynch, Staker, Stenglein, Fletcher, and also Cousins rotating through that forward line.
And again, Judd, touch number four, not as effective as the other three.
And there's Cousins up in the forward line, just trying to give the Eagles a bit of a spark. Some crumbing power up forward.
11 possessions for Ben Cousins. Good's taking his turn. Selwood, it was already over. 14 possessions for Selwood. Jolly and Seavey. Hearn, straight to Kirk. High tackle though.
I'm just going to cross something.
And it goes to Hearn. Decides not to give to Butler. Instead, searching for Staker. And he's got Chris Judd just there. Ignores him. Goods went to Judd, so that allowed Staker some room to try and go for Lynch. Once again, it's out very wide and hard for them to handle.
Leo Barry looking for the free kick, none forthcoming. Inside West Coast attacking 50. Seavey put it down onto the turf. Quick kick out of the pack, Stenglein's there, it's a free kick, advantage paid! Banfield kicks the goal, West Coast get another. Here they come. The opening two goals of the third quarter go West Coast way. There's the free kick to Stenglein against Bolton. And the umpire was right there. Perfect position. Paid the advantage. And Drew Banfield kicks the 75th goal of his 257 game career.
Suddenly it's Paul Roos with things to think about because this West Coast Eagles side appears rejuvenated. A couple of goals, they mean business. 19 points now the margin. Still a long time left in this game. Chris Judd just wearing the tackle there.
Has there been any noticeable difference so far, Steve, in this third quarter?
Well, I just think they're starting to win a bit of the football. They've restructured their forward line. They've opened it up a bit. Stenglein, as I mentioned, went forward. Also Cousins.
They just seem more committed, aren't they? They're winning the contested footy. Banfield against Buchanan. Buchanan's been a fine player tonight. Banfield kept it alive for the Eagles, showing that they are taking a positive approach. Imbley's wobbly one. Fletcher's going to get a free here. Things are definitely swinging the way of the West Coast Eagles.
Things are happening for the Eagles. They're starting to win the clearances. They're 5-0 up this quarter.
They stay out of the 50 for as long as they can to try and give Lynch some room. Still he goes to Lynch. He should get this. One. Not the second. Was that high? It was. Jolly's given away another free in the forward 50. And he's gone down. He's hurt again.
23 free kicks to 10.
Thanks, mate.
And Scott McLaren is up to 8 free kicks to 0. Not alleging anything here, just saying it's 23 free kicks to West Coast. McLaren's given a lot of free kicks to West Coast and under Sydney so far.
I just want to go back to the Lynch contest. At least he led up the middle. At least he led up the middle and there were crummers there.
What a transformation in this game. Waters lets himself down. And the Eagles, 3 goals the difference.
In fact, make it 9 free kicks to 0. To umpire McLaren in favour of West Coast.
Darren Jolly did not come out of that all that well. He's on his feet, he's still out there.
If you have a look at the top of the screen, there's a secondary huddle by the Swans. The Swans will go wide, and then that secondary huddle at centre-half four for the Swans, they'll break from there.
Ty Connelly tries to break the line. He goes short, finds Kirk. The West Coast pressing. And Sydney now just going to play a little bit of tempo footy, hold things up. Canelli to the hard run of Goods on the wing. Will he get there in time? He does, and he keeps the ball alive. Beautifully done, Adam Goods. Puts Sydney inside 50, but getting back to take a saving mark is Hearn. It's a risky kick, but it's come off nicely as he switches to the outer side, and Graham. Oh, superb kick to the wing. Here they go again, West Coast. Staker, he's been good this quarter. Chips to half forward to Cousins. Cousins to Stenglein. He gets there. Yes, he does.
Better movement. Quick movement started by Hearn in the back pocket.
Tyson Stenglein kicks in direction of Jones, who flies. Can't take the mark. Follow the ball. Judd. Judd. Misses just. It was all set up for a commentator's dream.
You're about to take off, I mean, Cordis.
And once again, the kick was to the spot. Top of the square. They've failed to do that for most of the game.
How quickly a game of AFL football can change.
There's that secondary huddle. The Swans forwards all huddle there, and they'll break once they get the first kick away.
They're having trouble getting it there at the moment, Soss. Ablett can go over the top, but he can't because there's no clear Swans just at the moment. O'Keefe having to work up from that huddle you were talking about to try and provide an option.
I'm just wondering whether the call will come out from the coach's box of the Swans, whether they'll try some tempo football.
Darren Jolly having a rough old night. That's the second nasty one he's copped. Richards doing the ruck work there, or not doing the ruck work, because Seabee got the tap, but Buchanan with the spoils. Over with Punder's head. Dangerous time for this pretty young Eagles defence, because Barry Hall is in command at Subiaco. His kick is long, but just astray. Well, that would have been very timely for the Sydney Swans, who are on the back foot. You can see Jolly is back on the bench.
3-1 to Barry Hall.
That's the average kick-in time. Just have a look how slow Sydney are tonight.
And a turnover.
They needed to take a bit longer that time, I think, West Coast.
Schneider. Leads on in the pocket to McVeigh. Tight angle. Jared McVeigh has had a good year in front of goal. He's kicked 15 goals, 3. This will have to be his very best. Got the West Coast flag in his way. And it's a poster. Gee, made a great fist of it, but not quite good enough.
One of the positives, I would have thought, for the season for the Swans, Jared McVeigh's development, Sauce.
Yes, played. I think he's played all the games, if not most, but just keeps... They tend to hold their youngsters back a little. They've got a number of players coming through the system.
Yep, every game this year is played.
That's great.
Now, we're Punder. The Eagles' momentum hold just slightly at the moment, but Staker, too hot to handle. Roberts Thompson showing that Silvani taut dash. And the kick was about as good too. Butler cleaning up. Banfield over to Hearn. Still no real loose man on for the Eagles, so going along to a one-on-one. If anything, the numbers with the Swans when it hits the deck here. Good solid work by Stenglein, and now Fletcher. Cousins is the get out at the back. Blind handball. Bolton brilliantly tackled by Stenglein. Handcuffed him in. Well done, Tyson Stenglein. This game going up a notch in the third quarter. 8-7 the Swans, 5-6 the Eagles. Saturday night footy. Have we got a Saturday night special at headquarters? Or will the Swans go on with it?
Hard one to call at the moment as Good smashes it towards the wing and gives his teammates a bit of respite. 19 points to diff. These are the matchups at the moment in the West Coast Eagles forward line. Gardner against Richards. Very ambitious from Ted. And he's given away the free kick. No doubt about that one.
He stands 192 centimetres, Ted Richards.
Yes, and that's why Darren Jolly needs to get himself right.
Gardner kicks to the 50. Goods with courage. Oh, well done, Adam Goods. He knew Stenglein was coming. He stood his ground. Tim Gossage.
Sydney have worked the interchange overtime in this third quarter, but West Coast only made a handful of changes. Andrew Embley came off the ground for about 40 seconds. Now back on in defence.
Cousins firing it in for Chris Judd. Now Quinten Lynch is moving into the pocket. Again, a very wide lead, but he's got some confidence. He holds on to this one. Can he nail it from the pocket? Takes the glove off.
Yeah, the glove's off.
As he always does. Judd providing the service. So the glove's off, and now the all-important putt. Just the one disposal for the night, and the one mark for Quinten Lynch. But he's kicked one goal, and another one would really get the crowd going. It's short. Waters couldn't get it through. Roberts Thompson, not quite like Mel Michael last week, but at least conceding the behind.
I don't want to harp on it, but Quinten Lynch once again to the pocket, to the boundary line. Always tough to kick goals from there.
You're harping, Steve.
Okay. Just Gosh actually said that Tim Gosh actually said about the interchange of the Swans. I reckon they realised that West Coast are very good last quarter teams, and they've won 7 out of their last 8 last quarters in recent weeks.
So intentional out of bounds goes, and some idiot's thrown something on the ground here. Barry Hall's got the free kick, and he goes short to O'Loughlin. Piece of fruit or something being thrown on the ground. O'Loughlin chips into the pocket cleverly, very cleverly. Oh, that was nicely worked, and McVeigh didn't let him down, and he'll have another shot at goal, a much better angle. It's still tight, but much more gettable for Jared McVeigh, and given the fact he almost nailed a difficult one last time, this should be okay for him. Jared McVeigh up to 15 goals, 4 for the year. Just past the halfway mark of the third term. Oh, two posters in a row to Jared McVeigh.
Either side, I think. Well, fresh hope for the Eagles. Hunter willing to go across the face and keep it moving. Jones and Butler collaborating, and now to the wing. It wasn't great service there for Hanson, but time was on his side. A couple of Eagles providing pretty good options. McCrae for Cousins again. Not clean, and again he has to work well. He went back a third time and still couldn't take it. And Jones losing it to Hall. Ragged around the edges, the Eagles. And again, they don't synchronise with each other. What's going on out there? Both teams making mistakes galore. Hanson, no free, advantage paid. Waters. Barry saving the day yet again, as he's so good at doing.
Great tackle by Hanson. Interesting to see Judd coming off the ground. Paul Ruse has opted for Goods to come off the ground with him, so obviously saving Goods' legs.
Kennelly goes short to Barry, who goes back to Kennelly. And off he goes. Two bounces as he takes it outside defensive 50. Now he switches to the outer side. Actually, it was well worked by Kennelly. That was beautifully done. Oh, Keith got a bad bounce, went without it. Manages dish off to Kirk, who's run down. Well done, Eagles. They've got the extra man here. But a little soccer off the ground favours Ablett. He's dragged down as he went to kick. Umpire says play on. Weirpunda, oh, skill. David Weirpunda, magnificently done. He goes into the middle. And he finds Butler. Butler has a steadying bounce. A long kick. Hanson's got the sit. Hanson, can he take the mark? No, he can't. Oh, big opportunity there for West Coast. Hanson couldn't grab it. And Sydney lock it up. Desperate stuff. Great football from both teams.
Good work.
10 out from the Eagles' goal. Rove by Waters, but he couldn't get boot to ball. Sydney repel. Fosdyke, a long kick to the wing. It's all set up here for CB to mark uncontested, but he missed a put. Hunter, short. Butler, Little underground handball. Oh, caught high. That's a free kick. That's going to Jamie Graham.
Tim Gossage, just how slippery is it down there?
Stephen, very slippery this side of the centre circle, and they are having trouble drying the ground out.
Hanson this time, though.
They've had some opportunities there forwards.
Absolutely no doubt about that free kick. Against Damon Buchanan and Jamie Graham.
Swan setting up their kick out.
½ gone in the third quarter. Sydney lead by 17 after leading by 32 at halftime. The big question is, how much is this fight back going to take out of West Coast legs? They have pressed and pressed hard. Crowd lifting. Sydney kicked a half back, and that's knocked over the line by Hearn. Shannon Hearn, taken pick 13 in last year's national draft from South Australia, playing game number 5 for West Coast. Thrown on the wing, Richards the tap. And now he kicks as well to half forward, O'Loughlin. Snared by Schneider. A little daisy cutter to Hall, who dropped the mark. Hunter's away. It's been a fantastic duel.
Great kick.
And it was a great kick. He set it sauce as he hits Lecrae on the chest.
Hanson again, the man. Again, he's got too many Swans to contend with. Jones working around the back. Oh, Stenglein can't believe he didn't get the free.
Behind the side. One arm over his shoulder is a free kick.
I heard the adjudication. Brett Kirk, possession number 17, again, trying to take the sting out of the game.
Well, you just wonder whether Sydney are trying to play a bit of tempo. They've had 32 kicks and 3 hand passes. So they're basically just chipping the ball, not running it.
Barry Hall unhappy with the service. He's getting 50. There. That's 50. Well, the Swans are really struggling at the moment. The Eagles haven't been able to capitalise as much as they would have liked. Hall wasn't expecting the ball to come at that stage.
Well, Judd sneaked on, and Goods is screaming from the boundary line. He wants on. So they've got just caught them napping here, West Coast, as Goods just prowling the boundary line.
So the Eagles making their move. Again, it's long. Stenglein outsized. No free kick. The team tackle. Watch out. Watch out, because Chris Judd was around. And so was Quinten Lynch.
Oh, yes.
Somehow. Quinten Lynch has invented a couple of goals in this quarter, and Chris Judd, who didn't have his opponent for the match in Adam Goods, was able to get it to him, Sauce.
Well, the ability to stand up in the tackle and get the ball out to Lynch. Great snap. 2 great goals by Lynch this quarter.
Crowd lifting. Sellout crowd at Subiaco. There's the goal assist from Judd. Lynch. Second goal of the quarter. West Coast have sliced back the margin to 11 points after trailing by 32 at halftime. CB the tap. There's Phillips in his first game. Lost his feet. Judd. Handball out. McVeigh under the pump. Tackled by Weerpanda. He's over the top of it. The umpire will bounce. Everyone takes a breath. Knocked back to the wing. Embley against Dempster. Picked up by Buchanan. It's a free kick. Go to Embley for in the back.
Straight back's on.
Andrew Embley. Being quiet, very quiet by his standards. This is just possession number 5. High ball. Hanson against Roberts Thompson. Roberts Thompson fists away. Falls to Butler. Ducked the tackle. Judd Fired it out to Braun. Got it to Selwood. Intercepted by Phillips. Back to Goods. Oh, Goods did well. To the wing. Dempster. Oh, didn't look at the football. Just looked at his opponent. Staker. Judd. Kept it alive. Oh, bang. Braun. Collides in a Fosdyke. Braun kept his feet. He's chased down. Great tackle. Quick kick out of the Packers by Jude Bolton. Very, very good vision by Jude Bolton. And now Buchanan's got it for Sydney.
Oh, this is wonderful. Scrapping football. Dempster lets fly. And here's the joust between Hall and Hunter. And again, it falls for the Eagles. Hearn and now Judd. Good's not able to get there. Two on the mark. There's some loose Eagles. Where are they? In the middle. Watch out. Well done, Ted Richards. Barry Hall. He's got Richards free. Took too long. Too late, she cried. And the ball's away. Ends with Hanson. And the move comes from Hall's opponent, Hunter. Out for Rowan Jones. The Eagles are pressing again. Stenglein, an unlikely target up forward, is causing them some trouble. Goes short for Graham. And still they wait to launch. Now it comes. Oh, well-weighted. Hunter, the man who so often is thrust forward, has done it again. This time, he's still on Barry Hall.
Where's his man, Sauce?
Well, he's in the middle of the ground. But Barry Hall, you just see him get tackled there. You've got to realise this is a high-tempo game at the minute, and you haven't got that much time.
So a bold move by Adam Hunter to run off Barry Hall. Not rewarded. It still might be. Oh, the Swans under siege at the moment. 10 points the difference.
Lynch has almost taken that again. Got his man out of position. Gets his hands to it.
He's kicked two goals for the quarter, Sauce.
No, but could have kicked four.
This is a gladiatorial battle. We've still got a quarter to go. A quarter and a bit as the two grand final teams of last year go at it again. Kick into the middle. Kurtz found some space somehow. Now can he use it? To half forward O'Keefe. Been quiet this quarter. The lead's on from O'Loughlin. He's found 10 metres. Great kick. And O'Loughlin will go back and kick for goal. He's been in very good form, but has been well held tonight as Hall sits down for a break. It's been 27 minutes since Sydney's last goal, and this, in the scheme of things, is a crucial kick.
They do that so well, the Swans. Bring their forwards up around the centre-half forward position, have space behind them, and they're able to run onto the ball.
So some adjustments to the right boot of Michael O'Loughlin. Now he gets his 30 seconds. Oh, a big kick this one, Sauce.
It is. They've been under siege.
O'Loughlin getting hooted by the crowd. In he comes from 35 outs. He's missed. He's missed badly as the goal umpire goes down. It's out on the full.
Throwback to the grand final last year where Michael O'Loughlin didn't have his kicking boots on either. So it's still only 10 the difference.
Just doesn't have any momentum when he comes in.
What a quarter by the Eagles. Jolly to try and spoil Gardner. And what a quarter ahead for us. What the Swans wouldn't give for a late goal. They might get their opportunity here. Buchanan was trying to get it back to Goods. But things are starting to swing the Eagles' way. McVeigh versus Graham. And again, it falls for the Eagles. And it's in the hands of Judd. But not for long, because here comes the big Q, Quinten Lynch.
11 disposals this quarter to that man, Chris Judd. Can't keep a good man down, Hutto.
Just that little tap there by Wirrupunda enables Judd to get free.
And Quinten Lynch, who's copped some criticism from our fellow commentator tonight, Stephen Silvani, has responded so far with two goals in the quarter. But he can't kick accurately that time. And it's 9 points the difference. And really, they've had some chances, Soss, to be almost in front by three-quarter time.
Well, 6-11's not a good result.
Can't quite steer it home, the big Q. Now, Buchanan's gone down off the ball, and Sydney getting a free kick. They're getting up pretty groggily, too, is Eamon Buchanan. Trainers out everywhere. And he manages to take his kick, and he finds Dempster. Buchanan looks okay. Dempster on centre wing. Kicks in the direction of O'Keefe, who's worked under the ball nicely by Waters. They had a throw in. Now under a minute to go in the third term.
The Eagles have worked very hard this quarter. What they don't want to do is allow Sydney a late goal here.
Jolly's back on against Gardner. Swatted forward by Gardner. There's Judd, 12th for the quarter. To Rowan Jones, scrubs the kick to the wing. Cousins. Handball intercepted by Fosdyke. Left foot kick. And we'll have a throw in. So this is all set up, fellas, for a classic last quarter. Sydney by 32 at halftime. Margin now back to just 9.
We were here last year in the qualifying final quarters. It was 4 points that day as well. That time it went to the Eagles.
And remembering Big Cox saved the day in the last minute, Hutto.
He did. A
couple of telling marks. Stenglein. High ball to half forward. Hansen. Goods. Pushed. Free kick. That'll be it for three-quarter time. Sydney lead West Coast by 9 points in front of the sellout crowd of 41,000 people. Stephen Silvani.
Well, it's all set up for a great last quarter. 3 goals, 8 that quarter, the Eagles. To Sydney, no goals, 3. Look, they're winning the footy. They've got some system going to their forward line. They're winning the clearances, the Eagles. Have the Swans got what it takes to hold them off?
Who's going to finish with the fresher legs? Will it be the reigning champs, Sydney? Well, the West Coast Eagles on their home turf. It's going to be a great last quarter. West Coast coming and coming hard at the reigning champs. They have cut a half-time 32-point deficit to only 9 points at the last break. Sydney 8-8-56. West Coast 6-11-47. Judd had a dozen touches in that third quarter. He's got a game-high 21. Goods 19 for Sydney, his opponent. Lynch 2, Selwood 2 for West Coast. Hall 3, Goods 2. For the Sydney Swans, as we have a look at key legs, the match has been going 91 minutes, Soss. Ben Cousins has only had 4 minutes on the pine.
Well, that is a worry, because they're going to need some running this last quarter. Sydney have saved their legs, but look, their midfield hasn't done that much of a rotation, but Fletcher's the one that they might use a lot in this last quarter.
Seems that quite a few Swans have had a little bit more of a break.
They have, but Jude Bolt, he's the one that may do the hit-up work for the Swans.
Tim Gossage.
Yeah, I can tell you now that Sydney Swans have made 49 interchange and West Coast just 39. That's plenty, though, on a night like this. Chad Fletcher gone for the night. Left hamstring. A bit of blow for the Eagles midfield.
All right, so another runner gone for West Coast. What a last quarter we're set for. Sydney start 9 points in front.
Butler begins the move, and again it's Stenglein playing forward. He's trying to nullify Canelli, but he's proving dangerous as well. Hansen, he's done some very nimble work, but his disposal has been below standard.
Hasn't been great, hasn't played for a number of weeks in this Eagles lineup. Maybe he's just getting used to the tempo. High pressure game this.
Buchanan, who copped a heavy knock late in the third quarter, is okay. Little chip to Bevan. Bevan's told to go, and go he does. Long kick in the direction of Jolly against CB. Judd from the side. Lifting at the business end of the match. Chris Judd, 22 disposals. Four marks, six clearances. One goal, one. Kicks to half forward. Goods does the spoiling. Buchanan happy to see it over the line. Feigns for the free kick. Umpire McLaren says, chuck it in. The mark from Chris Judd as Buchanan gets up a little gingerly. Jolly got nudged under it by Seavey. Umpire let that go. Kicks inside. The Eagles attacking 50. Ablett backed himself. Won the football. But his kick was intercepted by Butler. Butler bangs it long. Lynch flies from the side. Nudged out of the contest. Well, it's a hot ball here. Lynch again. Tripped over his own feet. Leo Barry. Sees some space and goes. Kicks to the wing. Hall, third man up. Free kick to Selwood, though. Umpire McLaren right on the spot. So Adam Selwood, who started this game in a blaze of glory with two goals. Been quiet since quarter time, but he helped get things going. Embley, who has been quiet, to Braun, to Hansen, who has worked very hard. And he's got the mark, 60 from goal. Centering kick. No mark taken by Hunter. Butler, Seavey, Rowan Jones stripped of the football. O'Keefe run down. Cousins kicks. Desperate stuff there. Whoa. Deep in the Eagles attacking 50. This is great, a great footy, game of football.
Great footy, plenty of pressure, plenty of commitment, desperation, the tackles, sensational.
Free kick against Kirk. You can see it coming. Kirk had no eyes for the ball. And he's been caught red-handed. Here it is, watch this, watch Kirk there. Just... no doubt about that.
Bit soft.
Well, got to let the player have a run at the ball.
Oh.
And a bad miss from Rowan Jones. That's a terrible miss.
How did he miss that? 6-12 to 8-8.
I didn't have any problem with the free kick.
You wouldn't. Waters are a bit soft.
Oh, soft. Come on
a bit.
Now. Don't be like that.
Bolton goes for Roberts Thompson. Serious business out here. 8 points the difference. And the Eagles doing everything but convert at the moment. The Swans have really been slow and stodgy in their movement, haven't they? It's a tough time.
They've lost their flow and very stagnant. This is it's been their problem.
Fosdyke tries to hit Hall. It's a good target. Now Barry Hall. He's got Dempster and O'Loughlin deep. He fancies Bolton. On the short lead. So can Jude Bolton carry the 50?
Just about his range, Shadow, I reckon. Just.
7 goals, 2 for the season. 13 possessions for the night. This, his most important one by far. And again, finding the target is proving beyond most at the moment. 6-12 West Coast, 8-9 Sydney.
Embley's got Brett Jones on in the back pocket, and that's who he kicks to. Off he goes. Now caught in two minds. Oh, gives it back to Embley. He's forced to kick hurriedly, but it comes off all right. And the mark's taken by Hearn. Shannon Hearn, the late inclusion for Glass. No one on the mark, so away he goes. A long driving kick. Lynch. Sport by Leo Barry. Umpire said it's a free kick.
Back here.
Well, he's kept working, Lynch. Umpire was correct here. Took the arm away over the neck.
So Quinten Lynch, a thumping kick right into the goal square. They fly and the Swans concede a rush behind. 12 free kicks given by umpire McLaren to West Coast. He's given one to Sydney.
What are you trying to say, Stu?
31-13, the free kick count in favour of West Coast.
That's huge.
Swans have only managed two goals since quarter time. And they are just clinging on to this lead at the moment. Roberts Thompson.
Let's go, play on!
Can they manoeuvre the ball forward? This is Paul Bevan. Can only see one-on-one contests ahead. Treading water, waiting for something. He hopes Dempster's the option. Did he hold it for long enough? He did. Mark paid to Dempster, who's done a very good job quelling Andrew Embley tonight. Only 8 possessions for Embley. Normally averages 19 a game. And hasn't scored a goal either. Dempster has, though. He goes for half-forward. Hall again. Got Hunter out of it. We're Punda. Selwood. A little scrappy, but no one there to take advantage. Along the line, Bolton. Well protected by Matthews. Now, Hall pushing back inside the 50. Calls for it again. He's one-on-one with Hunter down the line. No one else in the road, so it would be a reasonable option. Goods and we're Punda is a mismatch here. We're about to see whether Goods can capitalise. Did all the hard work. No, was that deliberate? No.
8-7 in last year's grand final. Tonight we've got 8-6. Inside Sydney's attacking 50. Richards against Seabee. Hacked out of midair by Seabee. Gained 40 metres for his team. Braun against Matthews. Coming into the picture is Ablett. Great tackle, Braun. Umpire will penalise the Sydney Swans. Umpire McLaren.
One-arm free, he's saying.
He didn't make an attempt.
Let's have a look at it.
Follow the jumper.
Another free kick, and it's going West Coast way. It's going to be taken by Lynch. Quinten Lynch kicks into the man on the mark. Leo Barry, Banfield, just bullocks his way forward. Spills to Braun. Now Staker. Into the corridor. Looking for, but unable to find Hearn. Socket off the ground by O'Keefe. Here's a big play coming up.
It certainly is. Hunter with a couple of yards on Hall. Good protection. Great run from Jones. Cleared the path. And now it's with Hearn. The Eagles try and sort it out on the wing, and they've got some options. Here's Quinten Lynch. Suddenly realises no one coming. Gives it plenty. Bevan under pressure. Vogel's back there as well. Handled it nicely. Got crunched by Waters.
Umpire.
He got crunched. Jones got the 360. Judd was ready to go. But the free kick is coming back.
You just sense the Swans are trying to defend this lead rather than win it.
Got to protect the player, for goodness sake.
And it was Waters earlier in the year on Copeland, you remember, who got reported. Got a couple of words when others thought it might have been more.
Let's go to Tim Gossage.
Working very much on Ty Canelli's lower back. He is really struggling. I know Buchanan's just come on. He's cramped up. Schneider looks very tired. The Swans are running on empty at the moment.
Action stations, though, on the wing. Goods. O'Keefe, good body work. Selwood wins the day and wins it with style. Jones, Hearn. Suddenly, the pressure is on the Swans again. That was very, very slick work from Waters. Now Gardner. Oh, as awkward as you could possibly imagine. Well done, Dempster, and well done, Leo Barry. Did he bite off more than he could chew? No. Lewis Roberts-Thompson running the gauntlet again, the Swans. Bolton gives it to Matthews, and it all opens up for them.
Matthews, the pass to the wing to Fosdyke, who led Weir Punder to the ball, but to the boundary line beat him in the end. Nearing the halfway mark of the final term, grand final rematch has been a beauty. There's the free kick count. 33-14, that is an amazing discrepancy. Selwood through traffic, kicks to half forward, big pack fly. Lynch does the roving, throws the ball on the boot to the 50. Bevan couldn't control it. He's met by Waters. Throw, says the umpire. Free kick going Sydney's way. And it's going to be taken by Bevan. Swans hanging on. They're in front by eight. Bevan. Long lead from Goods. And he takes it just before the boundary line.
Surely something's going to happen. It's
something's got to give, doesn't it?
They just need to find a target, the Swans. They haven't got a mark inside their forward 50.
They have not kicked a goal in the second half, the Sydney Swans. They've got it to half forward. Bodies flying everywhere. It's a free kick. It's going Sydney's way. Mark take the free kick given to Bolton. He got barreled in the back. Long ball. O'Loughlin's one out. O'Loughlin, not quite. West Coast have the numbers. Hunter, good handball, Eagles away.
McCrae, and now Hearn. And again a mistake. It's a hot ball out there. Roberts Thompson with some good options at centre half forward, but a bit of risk involved. Decides to play safe and wait. And eventually McVeigh is the man.
And they need a whole possession here. The Swans, their backmen are under enormous pressure. And they've held the fort for most of this quarter.
O'Keefe goes for Hall. Three to beat O'Loughlin. Hall! Somehow he held on. And it was all a bit easy in the end.
Well, it was. Big kick for the Swans. They're tied. The Swans are tied. They need to kick a goal here.
Some good protection there from O'Loughlin.
Fantastic judgment. So Barry Hall, big mark, big goal, big man, big bad Barry. I think there was enough bigs. 44 minutes between goals.
The disappointing thing about this is Gardner not getting anybody on Barry Hall. Barry Hall actually having a bit of a word to Hunter there after he's taken that grab. What a contest that's been tonight.
A feisty Barry Hall kicks his fourth. Look at the clearances, how the Eagles have turned it around in the second half. 29-28 overall. 40,688, a sellout crowd here at Subiaco. Witnessing a fantastic game of football. The Swans now lead by 14. We've passed the halfway mark of the last quarter. Goods to the 50. Hall and the Hunter basically buffeted each other out of the contest. Now picked up by Hearn, switches to the outer side to Selwood. This is disposal number 20. To the wing, Braun. That's a free kick going West Coast way, no doubt about that. Had a hand over the shoulder. Bolton doesn't like it. And Michael Braun has the football slightly on the defensive side of the wing position.
Big maze of players at half forward. Hard to go to work in there, but well done by Bolton. Won the little mini battle over Staker. And the Swans, are they going to be rejuvenated by that last goal? Judd's gone quiet for the moment.
Judd and Goods playing on each other for most of the night.
Will Judd still have a say in this last quarter? Ablett for Hearn. This is Phillips. Ondae Boo turns it over to the worst possible man, but no damage done. Kirk. And now Goods starting to flow again for the Swans. Banfield just brushes him off. Phillips, get out of the way. He thought Hall was coming. Ripunda. Phillips desperate, but the Eagles steadfast and now starting to move it. Jones to the wing.
Oh.
Desperate stakes.
Oh, he's out.
Bevan in trouble. No, he's so reckless. The Eagles going forward. That's courage too. It's contagious.
Bevan is in big trouble. That is just courage personified.
Just hold it.
Two men just throwing their bodies without any consideration at all at the ball. Look at that. Bevan, eyes only for the ball. Brave stuff from he. Brave stuff from Embley. And Bevan has paid a heavy price. Gee, that is a sickening blow for Paul Bevan. Head first into the turf. And this is not what we want to see in our great game.
Unbelievable courage. Both these sides have got to be commended with the way they've gone about it tonight.
It's been a carbon copy of the grand final, hasn't it?
Incredible. Incredible.
And Paul Bevan with only eyes for the football. No regard for his own safety. Well, neither did Embley.
It's been the story of the Swans, though, their commitment. And they've got it back tonight. Embley on screen there. He was just as committed. Had a tough night on Sean Dempster, who's done a terrific job on him.
I'm not sure whether Bevan was out before he hit the turf or not, but
it appears so.
Not a great finish, was it, when he went headfirst into the turf. He's conscious, which is great to see. And they'll take all the necessary precautions here. Now, this little break in play gives both sides a chance just to take stock. Sydney lead by 14.
Paul Bevan back in for his third match of the year tonight. Let's hope he is okay. Chris Judd, he started well, then had a bit of a quiet patch, really led them back in the third quarter. Been relatively quiet in this last quarter, but he's still got 24 possessions. And good to hear the crowd trying to urge on and help Paul Bevan as he makes his way by a stretcher towards the Swans rooms.
And he's certainly conscious, which is great to see. Who's going to win, Sauce?
Well, you'd think the Swans are in... Well, they're in the box seat, but the Eagles, I'm sure they would have got together at that huddle there and said they've got to run. They've got to run and carry the ball, and they've got to continue to pressure the Swans. The Swans look tired, there's no doubt. Before the Barry Hall goal, they were out on their feet.
So off goes Paul Bevan. The 21-year-old playing game number 42 tonight, his third game for the season.
I have no doubt that during that break, Paul Roos would have got a message out to his players. There was 7-8 minutes left in this game.
They make a line down the middle ahead here of Bolton, and now they break.
Fire!
Nothing really clear, so he has to use his skills to try and find Bolton. He can't. Eagles calling for out on the full, but clearly not. 14 points the margin.
At half forward for West Coast, Seabee slaps it forward. There's O'Keefe for Sydney, can't control it. And we'll have another throw in. Swans just one goal in the second half.
Hunter pushing forward here at the minute. Hall back at centre half forward. Graham picking him up.
They led by 32 at half time. Great tap. Hearn backed himself. Long ball, tip of the goal square. No mark, Staker. Vogels is in there. Soccer off the ground by Waters. Waters has got it. Beau Waters kicks his fourth goal of the season. Beautifully done.
Fantastic goal. Stake of the contest, bringing the ball forward. Exactly what the Eagles big men have to do.
Well, good to see he's on his feet, Paul Bevan. Hopefully that's good signs. We'll get an update for you soon. His team, though, he's under pressure, Tim Gossage.
Don't think you can hear us, Hutto. They're screaming that loudly out there.
We'll get back to him in a moment. Swans again under siege. Bolton certainly under siege from Braun.
Goods was sitting in the goal square. They bring him back onto the ball. There's the Waters goal.
What a beauty. Now Richards doing the ruck work against Seabee. With Punda. And the Eagles again full of steam. Hanson has been good. He's got the crowd loose. Long is Lynch. Which option will he take? He will go long. It's made for big Quinten Lynch. Oh, they could have shared it between them. And it's Hunter who is the wild card yet again. The ace in the pack, Adam Hunter, has taken the mark. Forward he has gone. Graham is back playing on Barry Hall. And Adam Hunter gets the Eagles within two. Just has this amazing habit of doing this.
Well, he does. He does. He does it on numerous occasions, and he's been moved forward. You just know he provides a contest. But what a great mark under pressure.
It's a bit of a team mark, actually, wasn't it, between those two then?
What a versatile footballer he is, Adam Hunter. Sydney have led from the start. It's now only 2 points. Ablett throws the ball on the boot. It goes to the 50. Brett Jones beats O'Loughlin pointless. He kicks to the wing. The fist came from Vogels. Whip under. Almost a miraculous pickup. He gets bowled. Oh! Bang goes Waters. That is irresponsible with his head over the ball. Bolton. That was a very dangerous attack on the player, I reckon.
I'd like to see it again, Steve. Let's have a look at it. Oh, well, it wasn't a hip and shoulder.
Yeah,
he's gone
enough.
In front on.
Maybe I went too hard too early.
It was a little reckless, but he was committed.
Fair enough. Tim Gossage.
Paul Bevan has walked around the boundary line. He's now sitting in the dugout. He looks okay. I doubt whether he'll be coming back on, but that's good news. He is okay and got all his faculties about him.
Gee, with his head over the footy, though, you've got to be careful.
West Coast, one-on-one.
Kennelly goes short to O'Loughlin.
Jones struggling here on the mark.
Long ball to Goods. Play on, says the umpire. Five to go. Some tired bodies there, Stenglein. Kirk, get up. Fosdyke, kick smothered. Cousins, high ball to the wing.
No mark
Bolton. Oh, caught high was Phillips.
Which is not hard. So, Phillips, what pressure. He's out there. Does well, finds O'Loughlin. Good hit up target. Swans keeping it pretty open inside the 50. They're in no hurry, though. They need to score a goal, you would think, if they're going to win the Swans. Surely they can't hold on and defend a two-point lead. Here's their best chance for a while. Barry Hall left it behind. He's manic at the footy, Barry Hall. Just bangs it on there and finds the young man, Simon Phillips. What a moment for him. Well, 173 centimetres, 65 kilograms is what he's listed in the book. He is a goal kicker. He's kicked 30 goals in 9 games in the Sydney reserves. It's from the Sandringham Dragons. What an initiation into AFL football. How would you like to be Simon Phillips? Not quite the result he was after. 3 points the difference at Subiaco.
Tense stuff. With Punda short in the back pocket to Selwood. Pops it over the top to Butler. He's got to be quick. He kicks to the wing and finds Stenglein. In fact, it's Staker. So Staker. Sydney by three. He's been told to go. Didn't hear the call. Little clever underground handball was good. Now Staker is stripped of it by Kirk.
Well done, Kirk.
Throw in on centre wing. The margin in the grand final was four. Sydney lead by three. Seabee slaps it forward. Phillips forced to release. O'Keefe can't control it. Kirk with his head over the ball, ridden into the ground. Cousins ineffective handball. Ablett's in there for Sydney. Just throws the ball on the boot to half forward. Fosdyke's clean bowled. So's Banfield. Attacking at McVeigh and Weerpanda. Another throw in. Cousins here at Subiaco Oval.
Sorry, Quarters. Cousins has gone down. He caught one from Phillips. He's had a few hits on either side of the ribs. And he is doing it hard on the wing, Ben Cousins. Ablett watching closely. 3 points the difference. It's open in the 50 to the left of screen if the Swans can get it in there. They won't immediately, though. Chris Judd, Cousins. Judd kept on going. It almost fell for him.
Unbelievable pressure. Unbelievable pressure out there. Man on man. The Eagles trying to get a break here from one of these stoppages.
3 points the difference. 27 minutes. They were at it on the last day in September. Not quite as much at stake tonight, but you wouldn't know it the way they're going about it. Dempster. Judd in there. Seabee. Cousins. You can't stop him. Weerpanda. Short, but okay. Staker. Can they open it up? Can they move it quickly? They move it quickly, but wide. Waters just out of his reach. A sigh. Will they hold on, Sauce the Swans?
No idea, Hutto. No idea.
At least you're honest.
Jolly has copped a couple of high knocks tonight. Handball was astray. Ablett, fresh airy. McVeigh, Cousins kept his feet. Judd tried to get it to him. Oh, it's absolutely no room to move here. Great handball over to Judd, who bangs it long to the 50. Goods can't take the juggling mark. Canelli's there, taps it back to Goods. He's bowled over. Umpire waving, play on. Comes to Stenglein. Stenglein into the goal square. It's a goal as it was a touch.
Position to see it, the goal umpire. Eagles in front, Swans have to respond. They did need to kick a goal if they were to win the game. What is left in the tank? Eagles flooding. They've thrown everyone but two. Back behind the footy. Stenglein again, he kicked the goal. And now it's the Eagles who will be happy just to wrap it up. And it's the Swans who have got to try and get it going forward. Here's a chance. Phillips gets it forward. Where's Barry Hall? There he is. And there's 200 other players around him in no time. Canelli telling his teammates to clear out, try and open it up, Sauce.
They're separating the Swans. No one going for the ruck.
No one at all. Snyder on the spot. Leo Barry. Oh, he was almost a star again, Leo Barry.
Play on advantage.
Going the Eagles' way.
Weerpanda in the back pocket. Oh, the handball's intercepted by O'Keefe. Can he get boot to ball? He can. Into the pocket. Weerpanda, desperate dive. Play on, says the umpire. Ball's out of bounds. Is it on the full? No.
Right in.
Gee, it looked like it initially, didn't it?
What about the Richards dive in the goal square? Weerpanda's hurt his knee. Can be only seconds left. Throw in. Seabee misses it. Bolton! misses. Eagles by two.
Embley takes it. Is there time for the Swans? Who knows? This crowd will erupt if the Eagles get home. The Swans in command for so long. It's a wobbly one. Kirk, they are lifting. They are digging deep. They are trying everything they can. But the Eagles holding sway at Subiaco.
Don't forget, with the injury to Bevan, it'll be a long quarter. But how long? No one's got a clue.
Another Saturday night special. Barry, Roberts, Thompson, Kirk. Roberts, Thompson goes again. No one can get out of there. The rolling ball eventually comes to an end.
Not a player in the West Coast forward line. The Swans will try and hit it forward.
Roberts Thompson is the man who swats it inside 50. Phillips is there for Sydney. What an incredible game of Australian rules football. Could you have asked for a better game of football? Let's go down to Tim Gossage with the man of the moment who kicked the winning goal, Tyson Stenglein.
Absolutely. Well, Tyson, you and Sydney and that end of the ground, something about kicking a goal in the dying stages.
Yeah, well, it wasn't the best kick, but luckily it rolled through, got rid of Shepherd on the line and just wrapped.
You're in front for 4 minutes of this entire game.
Yeah, we've been doing that a bit lately and... You know, we just persisted and the second half was a lot better. I think our pressure was a bit poor in the first half and we picked that up in the second half.
Have the blokes spoken this week about revenging the grand final? Has it been of any interest at all?
No. We just try to put a good game together and, you know, we've been a little bit off the last month, but still getting the wins and this week was just a great win by the boys.
Well played today. That goal this time might provide some controversy in a day or two, but well done, mate.
Thanks a lot.
Well, having another look at it, boys, I reckon it was a great call from the goal umpire. I reckon it was over the line.
Yes, I tend to agree. But what a super game of football. These two teams really did play a hard brand of football. They were both committed. In fairness to West Coast, I thought they were finished at half-time. They just didn't have any run. Their forward line system didn't work. That's just the touch just over the line. I think the goal umpire was correct. But they found something, West Coast. They found something. And John Lewisfold there would be absolutely delighted. They kept Sydney to one goal after half-time.
32 points down at half-time, West Coast. They clawed, they scratched, they fought, they ran. We thought they may have run out of legs in the last 10 minutes. But they didn't, and they have got out of jail again. Let's go back to Tim Gossage.
Out of jail again?
Yeah, it's, as I said, you know, we're just trying to give all the fans the money's worth, so, you know, it's exciting to watch, but it'd be nice to have a comfortable win.
Absolutely. I mean, as I mentioned just before to Tyson, in front for just 4 minutes of the game, but I suppose at the right time.
Yeah, I mean, there's a very interesting stat made public during the week that out of 500 and something minutes, footy we've only left for 80. So, you know, we're in front of the right times and wrapped to beat Sydney because they're a very quality side.
I suppose a good sign is you are winning some close games but still not playing well. Where are you at as a club with the sort of last half dozen weeks to come?
Well, to be honest, I think last week and this week, I think we played pretty good footy. I mean, we rate Sydney very highly and, you know, they came out a bit harder than us in the first half, but to fight back the way we did, I think, you know, on the road to recovery.
And that's the Tyson Stenglein Sydney Swans into the ground. It's twice now.
Tyson and Adam Hunter too. So it was great for those boys to stand up when they did.
Well played, Skipper.
Thanks, mate. Cheers.
It was in that game last year when we were here in the qualifying final where the controversy over the mark, Stenglein kicked the goal.
Yep.
And Hunter a late goal as well. Wow.
Sydney led by 20 at quarter time, by 32 at half time, by 9 at the final change. And the West Coast Eagles have got up the line in an incredible game by 2 points.